Hey guys, just want to go over a quick video about the grip tools that I like to use and what I recommend. Okay, so these two are the tools I use to recommend a lot. They're the official Molex hand crimp and the engineer tools. This one of the smaller ones, PA20. Okay, now what I found the issue was that these actually weren't that good for PC building. I've also tried a lot of the PC mod crimp tools, and they weren't all that good either. So, well, I did have decent success with this one. I started using all the tools. All right, now my favorite is the official Molex tool, okay? This baby will get you a nice, clean, crisp crimp. Like the one in 18 gauge, okay? And obviously, I use official Molex terminals, they're the best. Let's demonstrate. Alright. Nice, clean, beautiful crimp, okay? Well, the problem is $250. That's a lot of money. Okay, you can consider, you know, as a good tool for your hobby. It actually resells, you know, around $200. So you only be about out of $50, but that initial cost is quite high. Now for a budget option, I recommend IWISS SN28B. Something about, I don't know how much it's around nowadays. I'll link it below. But even though I'm using 18 gauge wire, it actually works a little bit better than the middle one right here. Give it a nice pre-crimp. The wire. There you go. It's a pretty nice clean crimp. Right. Not as nice as the Molex one over here, which uses a more of an overlap crimp. This one penetrates into the wire. But, you know, about $30 tool versus $250 tool. Okay. Now for the smaller crimps, this is what I recommend. IWISS 3220M. Okay. Oh, one last thing. So a big thing about getting good quality crimps is making sure you have the right type of wire. I recommend using 18 gauge UL1007 wire. So a lot of other wires that you may find at the, you know, Home Depot and stuff, the sleeve is a little bit thick. Won't get you a nice clean crimp. Alright, so that's it. That's all for today. See ya.